Hi everyone, I'm in Oakville today. Behind me is the Driver Examination Center. Today we're doing G2 road test. We're gonna do a mock-up exam, take you on an actual route, and give you all the tips and tricks you need to pass your road test from the first time.
Now I recommend you to park backwards like this. So when you start your road test, you just go straight, you turn right, and you're on your way.
All right, so here we are in the car. We've registered inside and now we are waiting for our examinator to show up. I'm here today with my friend and an expert in this field, and he's gonna help us with this mock-up exam.
Hi everyone. So before the road test, examiner will come to you, to your car, to your where you're waiting in the parking spot, and he just ask you to start your car, roll down the window, and they want to verify your ID and ask you what's your name, what's your date of birth, what's your address, make sure you know your postal code, and then he goes around your car to make a circle check to make sure all lights are working in properly, and check signal left, signal right, brake lights, make sure you have good tires on your car, and make sure you have no windshield cracks, and honk the horn. Then he sit down inside your car and ask you to sign the papers. Before it was papers, right now it's iPads, and then you start your road test. So make sure you check your all blind spots, make sure you're checking your rear view every 5 to 10 seconds, and you're making signals, and speed limit should be over control all the time, and yeah.
If you have a windshield crack, would the exam be cancelled?
Yeah, exam not gonna happen if you have a windshield crack. If you have bad tires, if you signal left or one of the brake lights doesn't work, so it's not gonna happen. So make sure you have all this in proper condition.
And then can you rent a car?
Yeah, you can rent a car, you can use a rental car, you can use your friend's car, your family, like dad's and mom's car, like doesn't matter. But like if you're coming for the G2 road test, make sure you have a second person, because if you fail, examiner will ask you who's gonna drive you home, so they want to see the second person accommodating you.
Mm-hmm. And today we have sunny skies.
Yeah.
Is it okay to wear sunglasses or ask them, you know,
my recommendation to you, don't use the sunglasses for the road test unless it's prescribed, because examiners, they want to see your eyes, how you move your eyes, how you check in your rear view, how you check in your blind spot, so they want to see your eyes. So during the exam, it's like 10, 12 minutes, maybe 15 minutes, you're gonna survive without glasses. So my recommendation to you, don't use the sunglasses.
And if it's bad weather, would like in the winter or heavy rain, would it be canceled?
Yeah, if it's icy road or too much snow on the road test usually canceled or rescheduled. Mm-hmm. But if it's heavy rain, it's gonna be road test still it's not gonna be cancelled, yeah. So if you have bad weather conditions and road conditions, you drive as you feel safe.
For example, you don't have to go 50, 60,
yeah, whatever. For example, speed limit is 50 and too much water on the road, you drive as it's safe, 30, 40, as you feel safe. The main idea of the road test is safety.
Mm-hmm. And you, if it's raining or if it's snowing, you want to know where all the controls are in the car.
Yeah.
So you know how to turn on the windshield wipers, how to defrost your windows. Make sure if it's winter that you don't have snow.
How to defog your windows. Yeah. You should know all this stuff in your car or in the car you use for the road tests.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
Okay.
And if there is a big line, we don't wait. We just
If you have a road test appointment, don't wait in line. Right now we have COVID-19 situation. It's like big line to enter the road test center. But if you have road test appointment, just go straight to the door and there is the person. And you say, okay, I have a road test appointment today. And it's like they let you in without any waiting in line.
Mm-hmm. Okay. All right. So then we buckle up.
Yeah. Don't forget to buckle up and start your car. And let's go through the route.
Okay, starting the car, buckled up.
Okay, if you're ready, let's go to the right.
Okay, handbrake, put it down, put on D, show signal right. Okay, make sure no one in front.
No people, no pedestrians, no cars. We turn to the right and we're getting out from this parking spot. Here's no stop sign, we're turning right.
But
make sure it's no cars approaching from the left. And here we're turning right to Wycroft to the right. It's route number 2. Mm-hmm. If you're gonna go left, make sure you check our video with route number 1. But here's a route, second route.
It's a bit busy examination center, so there's a couple routes here.
Yeah, so we're going straight, speed limit is 50 kilometers per hour. If you have chance to accelerate till 50, speed up till 50. Here's just industrial area, not too much cars on the road, so you're going 50. When you're crossing intersections, you check your left, right, left. Make sure you're checking your rear view every 5 to 10 seconds and keep your speed limit under control all the time. If you see speed limit sign, check your speed and or adjust your speed, and we're going straight.
Exaggerate movements.
Yeah, chin up when you're checking your rear view.
Two hands on the wheel.
Two hands on the steering wheel all the time. Steering wheel should be under control all the time. At least one hand, but keep your both hands these 10 minutes, maybe 12 minutes for duration of your road test on the steering wheel. Okay, we're crossing service road. We keep going straight. Another speed limit sign is 50. And we're going till next traffic light. It's a third lane. And third line, we're gonna turn right. Third line is one of the major streets here in Oakville. And speed limit is 60. And you make your signal in advance. Your signal should click 5 to 8 times before you turn in right.
Three is not enough.
Yeah, 3 clicks is not enough before you make the actual turn.
Keep the safe distance between the front car.
Yeah, at least you have to see the rear wheels of that car and a little bit of the road. You have to have room for maneuver to escape from this situation without backing up.
Mm-hmm. But on red light, if you are the first one, you can make a turn on red light.
Yeah, after full stop before stop line, you can make a right turn on a red traffic light.
And if there is no cars on the left?
Should be no cars from the left in both lanes. Okay, so
check for any pedestrians, blind spot, for bicycles. Yeah. By the way, there's a bicycle.
Here we have a bicycle lane for bicyclists. So you keep attention for bicyclists. And the road is going down under this bridge. Make sure your speed limit is under control.
It's 50
it's
here.
60.
It's 50. Oh, it's 60 here?
60 here.
Okay.
And we're going straight. This traffic light, Spears Road, we keep going straight. As soon as the examiner will ask you to make a lane change to the left, you know that the next intersection, next traffic light, probably examiner will ask you to make a left turn.
Okay.
Okay.
left, right, left.
Left, right, left when you're crossing. And change your lane to the left. If it's safe, you decide if it's safe or no. And speed limit is begins here 50. And right lane is ending, so examiners, they have no choice as like the only way is change your lane to the left. If you see the lane in front of you is ending, you change your lane to the left by yourself with mirror signal and blind spot. And this traffic light, we're gonna turn left. It's a bridge road. We have special inlet for the left turn. Okay. Sometimes we have green arrow here for the left turn, but right now is not. So you're gonna advance in the middle of intersection and waiting for oncoming traffic in the middle of intersection. Or until traffic light change to amber. And then you complete your maneuver. Check for pedestrians. And you turn into residential area. And speed limit is 40 right here. And first intersection you turn left into the laneway court. And on this street, examiner will ask you to make a 3-point turn, parallel parking, and one of them is downhill or uphill parking. Let's keep going a little bit straight. So, this street, they have no curbs. So, it doesn't matter if it's gonna be downhill parking or uphill parking, you turn your wheels to the right.
All the time.
All the time, off the road. Okay. So let's make a 3-point turn right here.
Okay, I'm gonna make it just past this curve. Show signal right. Check if there's any cars front behind. Signal left.
Yeah.
Forward.
Don't use the driveways. Don't go in the driveways. You should make a 3-point turn in between two grass. Don't go to the grass also.
Turn. Signal right. Go back. Look back as we're going.
Yeah, when you're going and backwards, you physically look at the back window.
And getting out from here.
Okay, and let's make a parallel parking with this car. Make sure you practice parallel parking a lot with different cars. Minivan, pickup truck, sedan, SUV, because you don't know what kind of car is gonna be on the road test.
Okay.
So when you're making parallel parking in here, don't go to the grass. You have to be behind this vehicle, but your wheels should be on the road, not on the grass.
Mm-hmm. Okay, maybe adjust a little bit forward. Okay, put on P, handbrake, wheels all the way to the right.
To the right, you go off the road. Okay, yeah. This is great. Let's get out from here.
So the only time it's to the left is when it's uphill with the curb.
With the curb, yeah.
Okay.
The rest, any one situation to the right.
Okay, but here there's no curb, so...
So it doesn't matter uphill or downhill.
Examiner might say, pretend that this is uphill and there is a curb here.
Might be, but it's...
Small chance.
It's a very small chance, yeah.
Okay. They really mean.
Yeah, usually they might say it's not downhill, not just pull over to the right and park your car.
Mm-hmm.
And they don't like say it's like uphill or downhill, and then you decide.
Okay. Alright.
Okay.
Handbrake, put on rear, back out a little bit, show signal.
Yeah, when you're getting out from here, make sure it's no cars, no pedestrians. If you have some cars approaching from in front or from behind, just wait for them.
Put on D, signal left.
mirror, signal, blind spot, MSB formula.
Formula, like formula. MSB, mirror, signal, blind spot. Yeah, that's a good tip. Okay. So it's all our exercises.
Three-point
turn, parallel parking, and downhill.
Did we do... We didn't do downhill parking.
Downhill parking. Okay, pull over to the right and park your car like downhill.
Okay, show signal.
Don't go to the grass, you just park on the road.
Put on P, handbrake, downhill, wheels to the right.
Yep. Okay. That's good. Let's get out from here.
Okay, and you wanna park between the driveways.
Don't block the driveways. Yeah.
Try not to block, there's a fire hydrant there.
Yeah, 500 meters before, 3 meters after is no parking. It's a good idea to pass the fire hydrant if it's here. So mm-hmm. alongside the grass, another grass, another grass. You choose.
Okay, make a little straight. Handbrake, put on D, show signal. Check the mirrors, blind spot, and we're going.
And we're going, as soon as you made a 3-point turn, you're going back to examination center, same route, same roads. So this stop sign, we're gonna turn right to bridge road. This stop sign is only for us and we have a stop line. And make sure you made a full stop, 1 Mississippi, 2 Mississippi, 3 Mississippi. Okay, you turn it right, you check it right, blind spot for pedestrians. And this traffic light, we turning right to the third line.
Here we have yellow, so we stop.
Yep.
And now we see if there's no cars. There's no cars.
Yeah, if you can see green arrow from the left, it's and your turn. You can
here
go.
We have 50.
Yeah, here, right here we have speed limit is 50. It's gonna change to 60 after next traffic light, but right now it's 50 and we're going straight. Right now here we have one lane and it's divided by two. Be on the right side.
Right lane is for driving, left one is for passing.
For passing.
Stay in the right lane.
Stay in the right lane. And you're gonna cross this Spears Road, and after this traffic light, examiner will ask you to make a lane change to the left, and you know the next traffic light is gonna be left turn, and you're ready for the left turn. But here we're going straight.
And it looks like it's gonna go downhill.
Yeah, if road is going downhill, make sure your speed limit under control all the time, because plus 10 kilometers over speeding from posted speed is gonna be probably fail. It's considered like big mistake. So your speed limit should be under control all the time. When you cross an intersection, you check left, right, left, rear view, and right here examiner will say, okay, change your lane left if it's safe. And you decide if it's safe to do so, and speed limit is 60 begins here. Mm-hmm. And it's downhill, your car is accelerating really quickly. And first coming traffic light, we're turning left.
To the there's a special inlet here.
Wycroft. We have special lane inlet for the left turn. Sometimes you have green arrow here, and usually green arrow is working in the rush hour, morning rush hour ending at 9 a.m. and afternoon rush hour starting at 3 o'clock. Much more cars on the road after 3 o'clock afternoon.
So if you have a chance to book your exam, between 10?
Between 9 and 3 is a good time. Nine. Less cars on the road, you can make lane changes, and it's less traffic is easier for you to go through the road, test route.
Yeah, if you have, we just wait until.
Yeah. If you have one car already in the middle of intersection, it's a good idea to stop before stop line and wait until this car clears this intersection. If it's turning, right now we have a bus. If bus turning on the yellow, then you're gonna stay before stop line. If it's
green,
still
advance.
Green, you advance in the middle of intersection, waiting for incoming traffic, checking for pedestrians.
And you still wanna maintain the wheels kind of straight. You don't wanna turn.
Yeah, your wheels should be straight. Not turned left. Mm-hmm. Because in this case, if somebody hit you from behind, you're gonna go to oncoming traffic way.
Mm-hmm.
But you should be, wheels should be straight.
Be patient.
Don't be in rush. Right now it's traffic light is changing and we completing our turn in the left lane, and we stay in the left lane because right lane is ending right here.
Mm-hmm.
Speed limit is 50, accelerate till 50, and we're going back to examination center, and the last exercise is gonna be parking, front parking or back parking. Usually it's like 80% of back parking, reverse parking. Make sure you practice this reverse parking a lot. We have a special video how to make it perfect, like your reverse parking. You can learn it, this maneuver in 20 minutes. But make sure you practice a lot. And when you practice in reverse parking, practice it to the left, right, and to the right side, because you don't know what the examiner will ask you to make.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, speed limit is 50, crossing intersection left, right, left. Here examiner will ask you to make a left turn, not in the exit where you getting out, but like one exit before, right here. It's Autotronics after repairs, it's right here, and then we turn in right to examination center parking lot. Again, pay attention for pedestrians.
Go slow.
And some cars go slow. If you have some cars in front of you making some maneuvers, okay, let them finish that. And then let's make a reverse parking in place number, let's say, this is the one?
14? Or which number?
Okay, let's make it in
14. Or that one there.
Okay, let's make it in 14.
Okay, they're leaving, 1 second.
So make a signal to show our intention to make a reverse parking.
Mm-hmm. Okay, 14, right?
14, yeah. This is busy examination center, so...
Okay. This is the last exercise, so practice this one, and then put on P and brake, and turn off the car.
And at this point examiner say you're okay, you pass, congratulations.
Yay.
Go to the counter and get your temporary G2 license, and you'll get your new plastic card in 2 or 3 weeks through the mail. So this is the end.
So pretty straightforward, short, but you do wanna go and practice this. So what if you encounter maybe like a school bus in the morning or a fire truck?
Yeah, the rule with school buses, if school bus stops for pick up a kids or drop off the kids with hazard signals on or flashing lights and they open the stop sign, you have to stop 20 meters before the school bus. It doesn't matter it's on your side of the road or opposite side of the road, and all traffic just stops and wait until bus off the flashing lights. With police, firefighters and ambulance, it's you have pull over to the right. If they come in approaching your car with sirens and emergency signals, and you pull over to the right and stop, wait for them to pass and don't follow them less than 150 meters. And be ready, usually firefighters go in first, and be ready that like 30 seconds after, one minute after is going ambulance and or police. So make sure you pay attention.
Mm-hmm. And what are some of the ways that some of the mistakes people make that they fail due to? What are some common ones?
Most common mistake is not a full stop on a stop sign. It's called rolling. So make sure you make a full stop on a stop sign. No rolling at all. You count one Mississippi, two Mississippi, three Mississippi. Don't be in rush. Don't, because usually people, they want to go through the test as soon as possible. Like, but no, take your time. Another one, when you make a parallel parking or three-point turn, you hit the curb or touch the curb with your wheels. This is a big one. It's a fail. So practice parallel parking a lot. We have special video on this one. And make it perfect. And another one, and most common mistake, is over speeding, especially if you have a school zone on your route and speed limit is 40, or and you over speed like plus 10 kilometers from posted speed, it's gonna be a big mistake. And here we have downhill on the third line, and it's like your car is accelerating really quickly, so slow down your car if it's going more than 60 or 50. So keep your speed all the time under control.
Mm-hmm. Okay, and as we mentioned before, this is a big examination center, pretty busy, open 7 to 7.
Yeah.
So there's a couple routes here. This was one of them. Make sure you check the other video for the second one, because all of these cars can't go on the same road.
Yeah, they're going left and right from here. And another one is a good idea to come early, maybe 1 hour before the road test, go through this route and warm you up and calm down your nerves, and then 30 minutes before the road test you have to be on registration in the examination center. Another tip is right now is fall time and winter is approaching. So if it's really cold outside, it's a good idea to warm up your car inside and take off your winter jacket, because you have to feel comfortable. Your movements should be like free of any big heavy jackets.
Mm-hmm.
And when it's warm inside and outside is like bitterly cold. Examiner feel comfortable in the car.
They melt.
Yeah.
And they feel good.
Yeah.
You want to make them feel good. You want to make them feel safe.
Yeah. And you have to know how defrost your window, defog your window, and if it's like heavy rain and road conditions not so good, how your wipers work. So you have to know. You have to be familiar with all these like knobs in your car.
Yeah. Okay. I think that's it for G2 road tests. If you have any questions, please write them in comments below. If we didn't answer anything, we'll make sure to get back to you and answer your question. If you like this video and you found this helpful, please like it. It will help other people discover it. Please share your experience with the road test here. Let us know if you passed and how it went. And
let us know which route you went through.
Mm-hmm.
Which one is more
common?
Yeah. My experience is 50-50.
Mm-hmm. Okay, that's it. Okay. Thank you for watching.
We wish you best of luck for your road test and goodbye.
Bye-bye.